Covid announced 47 delegates. Sadly, it's 49 were female. 38 males, most of them shame.
Hi, Kev.
You'll be Peter at the Tribune News School. Hey, Derek Thompson, you're on the NEC now, you're going to behave yourself. I have known this, but I'm not keeping you long. As I say, I did this 5 years ago. I came up and I said to the scientists to do a good job. I must be sick of seeing the polls. So let's try this then. A handsome swan. Ever seen that? He's in his early 30s. I had a full head of hair. Can I give a thanks to the sailors and the PCS and the fellow because it's a really impressive job that they did. I'm trying to so many of them, so screw it up for the sailors. The NEC member brushes the hair out of his eyes and comes in. Media, the main lady in the team. It says he has to stand standing orders as well, so I'll stand standing orders, which I care with the other. Laura and Diane, who are recording the Commons decisions, Nick McCarthy's campaign team, and the redoubtable Theresa Brisby and the team, who did a fantastic job at all that. Paul Kennedy and the member of us, Sean Rudder, the Tellers, and Star Dennis for carrying Johnson's bag. Jess has taken the photographs to make sure they're fairly presentable, and Jason is up there somewhere doing the video and photography. The next one, Dave Watson as well, wish Dave Watson all the best. He's the Chief Policy Officer of Mark's Lock. He had a heart attack not long ago, and he is back in the back of the saddle. We wish him all the best. We haven't seen this after the last job with Dave at the NEC. Maybe on the NEC might get that one today. Turning out Janice, I think I said 5 years ago, I was proud of Janice being my president. I still am proud of Janice being my president. She's one of the senior most women in the trade union movement. She's strong, she's forthright. A knowledge of the rules, a knowledge of PCS policy is unsurpassed. She's helped me a lot, and I'm proud for her to be president. Thank you, Janice. Give you a look during NEC meetings sometimes, which means you have to shut up quickly, and we all know that look, so there you go. Turn up to the AGS, Chris Bloch. I've known Chris since we were young lads together 30 odd years ago. I am the same age as Chris. Don't laugh, because that's not your laugh, because we're all the same age. See, I actually have a harder feel around than Chris. But if you're at headquarters on a Thursday, you'll hear an alarm go off at 3 o'clock. Has anybody heard that when being announced Thursday? The alarm goes off, it's a fire alarm, then you hear another alarm 10 minutes later. And most people assume it's a bum alarm. And that's why actually Chris goes to the canteen to buy a cup of tea that's open in his wallet. And actually goes on. But no, I'd like to thank Chris for the work that he has done on finance. I am a member of the finance committee, and for the work that he's done on the green agenda. So thank you very much, Chris, for the work that you've done for the evening. DGSU Lanning, a Doggett, or is it Doggett? No, a Doggett associated. The work that he's done on personnel issues and international issues is fantastic. He gets called a lot, but as I say, he does do a lot of work. He gives us long, very long, reports on the NEC. So thank you, you, for the work that you do, especially on policy. Thank you, mate. Yeah. The NEC, my fellow colleagues, a much maligned body of men and women, do get called. You know, the NEC hasn't done this, they haven't done that. But I know, from being on the NEC, and I'm proud to be a member of the NEC, that they do a lot of work, chairs up down the country, we work in most branches, abused and some, and on board. So thank you, NEC, for the work that you've done, and we've got a lot more to do this year. People think that the NEC sits the county thistle and it's luxurious and all the rest of it. It's not that good, actually. I mean, you can't afford a drink in there for a start off. You do get a big bed. I mean, I've got a bed that's about 10 foot square. And you can get me.
That's not very big, actually.
I'm not very fat, and I'm not a lesbian there, you know. Sorry for putting that in your mind. But it was a good night. No, I mean, this is what you get for your shower gel. That's his one leg. There's another one for another leg. There was a little fire of shampoo as well, which I don't really use that much. But I use it somewhere else, but I'm not bothering you. But you might see this live at the boat conference this week. I have had sciatica. I also had an attack of the gout on Tuesday night, and my big toe. And they had a doctor actually in the thistle, and he actually came up to my room, gave us a couple of pills, which I was pleased about. And he says, "See, I take those." There were two blue pills. And I says, "Well, there's a few of the gout." He says, "No, it's Viagra." I says, "Well, I'm healthy." He says, "Well, they'll keep the blankets off your toes." And then delegates, because you are the lifeblood on the union for the debates that you've had and that you've actually done it in a nice manner as well. Tim McGann, I think that's Tim, you know, he's not one who walked down and wait all night, kid. I studied Tim's speeches and he actually mentioned thrashing himself a couple of times. So I'm just wondering what his hobbies are, but never mind. Thank you anyway, delegates, because you've done a good job. You have got a job of work to do, so thank you for your participation. Give yourself a clap. I've known him since he was 19, and as I say, I was a good president, and he came on the group executive committee of the then DHSF, now the DWP. He was a church-going Catholic at the time, and he came up to me and said, "Kevin, you're a Catholic, aren't you?" And I said, "Well, yeah. So next altar boy along with McFadden and McNally. And he says, "It's a holy name obligation tomorrow. What mass are you going to?" And I said, "Oh, I don't know." I said, "Which one are you going to?" He said, "The 8 o'clock." I said, "I'll probably go to the later one, but come on." But Mark has done the union proud and actually presenting and putting forward the policies of this union. I think that his appearance on Question Time is fantastic.
Yeah.
March was outstanding as well, and I was proud to be a member of the union on that day. I had tears in my eyes to see 30,000 of us walking along and actually protesting against the cuts. So thank you, Mark, for the work you do for the union.
Yeah.
That's a nice stuff out of the way. And one thing, Mark, generally I agree with him on policies all of the time, but on one thing he's deluded, he's deranged, and he's brain damaged. Of course, that subject is called a city. I actually sat with him in the pub watching the match when Redden thrashed them 3-0 the other night, and that was bad enough. But a half back to 2 years ago, when me and Mark were delegates at the TUC in Liverpool, and Newcastle were playing on a Sunday afternoon, my team, Newcastle, were playing called a city. So me and Mark, he nipped out of the general council early, and he had something important to do. And it was only me and him in the pub, and he started, offside. Foul, it's a disgrace. The referee's got a Newcastle shirt on under his top. And then, of course, he put together one or two passes, and he come up with a classic. It's like watching Brazil. Seriously deluded, I tell you that. Like, if I don't go on NEC, remember Steve Coleman, who's retiring, and Gladys Morris, I don't know whether Gladys is in, she's probably in the shop somewhere, until the back. It's got new career, which involves going around with Jeff Lewis's credit card in Paris, and shopping, and whatever. And Tony Conway is doing this as well, he's got a job with the union. I don't know quite what he's doing, but I was in HQ last week, I did see him up in a book with his name on it. So. And if you see me next week, Tony, I've got some photocopying for you to do. So. NEC meetings will certainly be a lot shorter with Tony though, than the NEC, I can tell you that. And Dave Peer, who was still here for another year, who stood down as HMRC Group President, he's been Group President for 9 years. He certainly supported me. I think he's a fantastic bloke. We will miss him. And thank you very much for that, Dave, you know. There was actually a song at the HMRC Conference called Dave Bean song. Because I think it's the tune of Jolene. It was Dave Bean. Anyway, we all love you, David, anyway. Well, most of us. So, conference, we've had a good week. We've actually debated a lot of motions. The main thing that we've got to do is go out and win that ballot for the 13th of June action. That's what we have to do. Start, hit the ground running, and make sure that we do that. As I say, I'm proud to be a member of PCS. I was never more proud than on the 26th of March, but also I'm proud to be an NEC member. And all the cabinet say we're all in it together. Well, I'm not in it with a cabinet of 16 or 20 millionaires, whatever it is. I'm in it with the trade unions, the pensioners, the welfare groups, the claimants, the very communities that will be devastated if we allow these cuts to go through.
Hear, hear.
Get out there, do the work, let's win that ballot. Conference, you've had a good week. Have a safe journey home. Thank you very much.
By saying we've got to leave Brighton united in purpose, united in politics, and united in action. I think this has been the most serious conference that I've chaired in 9 years. Well done to you all. Let's go back and win that ballot. Thank you.